Everyone, we're continuing to learn some priceless gems from the observations made by Dr. Fadel Saleh As-Samerai in his book, Al-Qur'ani. Those of you that haven't caught an episode of this before, he wrote a book that is about the beautiful, unique, really divine way of Allah expressing himself in the Qur'an. And he talks about phrases, just small phrases that Allah uses that are so unique and so telling. And what I want to do for you today is kind of lay the groundwork for one of the comparisons he makes in the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Mm-hmm. So before we go to the Arabic and show you the screen, I just want to kind of lay the scene for you. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, you know, he did a demonstration to his people about how the sun and the moon and the star don't make sense to be worshipped, right? Mm-hmm. So, and when he did that demonstration, obviously some people, when they read that, they think that what's going on is that he first thought that the sun or the moon or the sun or the star are God. But then when the morning came, he realized they're gone. So he said, oh, they can't be God. And then he's like, oh, but the sun must be it. Hada Akbar, it's bigger. That must be it because it's so brilliant. And then by the time sunset came, he's like, that can't be it, right? But that doesn't make any sense. Mm-hmm. It doesn't make any sense because Ibrahim alayhi salam is one of the most intelligent human beings that ever lived on earth. Mm-hmm. And it's not like he had to wait until sunset to all of a sudden shockingly realize that the sun was setting. You understand? Mm-hmm. Yeah. He was demonstrating to people how ridiculous it was that something that disappears like that, something that isn't a constant like that to you, is an eternal, never-changing, constant God, right? Mm-hmm. And he was demonstrating, oh my God, it's said. What are we going to do now? I guess that's not God. It's more demonstration than him going through his religious journey. So that's him demonstrating, right? And this is actually, tilka hujjatuna atainaha Ibrahim. This was a way of making a case. This was a way of demonstrating the truth about something and the falsehood about something that was uniquely given to Ibrahim alayhi salam. So if you compare, the way he preaches is different from other prophets. No other prophet was given license to break idols to make a point. Oh no. This time I will plug in. I don't know why he keeps unplugging the laptop. Oh, he forgets. Because we moved this laptop around. Hold on.
So you do like your Urdu thing?
Yeah, I take this laptop and... we gotta find the power supply before, yeah. Quick, before the laptop dies. Before dies the laptop. But it is plugged in. You did plug it in. Did it go away?
Yeah, it went away.
Okay.
Don't I look so Islamic, guys? And this, like.
He looks so Islamic. He looks like so religious right now.
And then I got this thing.
It's like, full Ramadan zone.
Yeah.
Anyway, what was I saying? Something about Islam or something?
Oh,
Ibrahim. So Ibrahim alayhi salam has a way of preaching and making a case to his people that was, you cannot compare it to any other prophet really, right? So other prophets, like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, also had idols in Mecca, but to show that the idols are not gods, Allah didn't inspire him to go break all the idols and then put the axe in the big one's hands and say the big one did it.
Yeah.
Even though he's following the religion of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And there were other, you know, Nuh alayhi salam, his time had idols too. Waddan, Suwa', Yahuth, Ya'uq, Nasra. Even the name of the idols are mentioned in Surah Nuh, right? But he wasn't given that way of making the case. Also, this almost sarcastic, demonstrative way of demonstrating how pointless shirk is in worshipping the sun and the moon, this was not given to other nations, right? So Ibrahim alayhi salam is unique in the way that he made a case. Mm-hmm. And so he, Allah, you know, expresses that when he says, tilka hujjatuna atainaha Ibrahim. So tilka is the mubtada, hujjatuna is the khabar. Atainaha is a reinforcement, and this is actually kind of a ikhtisas on the hujja because it's being referred to again. So that was our way of making a case that we exclusively gave to Ibrahim, mm-hmm. alayhi salam. So that's a side point. Anyway, so he is also unique. Well, wait, don't go to the ayat yet. Don't go to the ayat yet. So he's also unique in that he said something that you only really find in the Quran being said in that same exact way by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And that is that, you know, a time came, I talked about this incidentally yesterday, a time came where Allah gave the Prophet ﷺ license to no longer call them my people, to just simply say kafirun, right? And this concept is called bara'a. Bara'a means I have nothing to do with you. I disconnect myself from you. That concept is called bara'a, okay? When you're connected to someone and you're loyal to them, that's al-wala, al-wala. When you disconnect somebody and you say, I have nothing to do with you, I disassociate myself, that's called al-bara. So they say that, like in Islamic political sciences, there's like al-wala wal-bara, loyalty and disconnection. Who are we loyal to? Who are we disconnected with, right? But anyway, so Ibrahim alayhi salam actually declared his bara'a from his people eventually. Inna bura'a'u minkum wa mimma ta'buduna min dunillah. That's coming too. But there are two times where he says, I have nothing to do with the shirk that you people do. I am bari, I have bara from the shirk that you people do, right? And so now we can look at the ayah. Or there are two ayat. So one of them is from Surah Al-An'am. So the sixth surah, and this is the top Arabic is ayah number 78. So I'll write here 678. And this one, the second one, is actually Zukhruf, which Jawad is 43, is it? Am I mistaken?
I believe it's 43.
Yeah, 43:27. Okay, 43:27. So, one last thing before we dive into the comparison, because it's a really cool comparison. So, in a standard kind of thing you learn in Arabic linguistics is the concept of stress. One stressor or no stressor. One stressor or two or more stressors. Okay? Now let me tell you what this means in simple English. So no stressor is I ate ice cream. Mm-hmm. I didn't stress it at all. I just said I ate ice cream.
Yeah.
Okay? One stressor is wallahi, I ate ice cream. Okay, I swear to God, I ate ice cream. Okay, two or more stressors is, wallahi, I am telling you, bro, I so ate ice cream for reals.
Okay.
Okay. I know.
That's like old stressing, I guess.
Yes, it's old stressing. Why don't you give me new stressing?
Bro, wallah, dude. Oh my
God. Okay, wait, let me hold on. Let me write it out. Bro, wallah, dude.
Bro, wallah, dude. Like, bro, I devoured that ice cream.
Bro, I devoured
that ice cream.
Okay. All right. That's plenty of stressors, right? There's even a bro in there with a ha in it. Okay. Very good. So now in Arabic, in Balagha studies, we see that if it's one stressor, it's called kalam ibtida'i, and that means you're talking to somebody who is neutral. Neutral audience. Neutral audience means this person is just, you know, you just came in, I have no emotions towards your eating of ice cream, and you come in today and say, hey, by the way, Ustad, I ate ice cream. I was like, oh, cool. I don't really care, right? There was no emotional response from me. So you didn't have to get so passionate about your eating of the ice cream. You just said, I ate ice cream. There was no stressor, right? When you add one stressor, the neutral audience is about with no stressors. I put it in the wrong place. With no stressor, that's a neutral audience. Mm-hmm. Okay? When you have one stressor, you have a doubtful or unsure audience. So you kind of look like you got some vanilla coming out of your side of your mouth, and I'm thinking either, you know, you got the rabies, or you're foaming at the mouth, or I'm not sure what's going on, and so you're like, no, well, I ate ice cream. So you added one stress,
yeah,
but the stress was there to reinforce what I was thinking, because I could have been thinking a couple of things. Should we put you in a mental asylum, or should we wipe the ice cream from your face? Well, I'm not sure which one. So you made my uncertainty clear, and you said no, it was ice cream. Yeah. Okay, So that is when you add one stressor. Yeah. So with zero stressors, what kind of audience do you have, Mariam? For zero stressors, neutral. And when you have one stressor, you have a doubtful audience. When you have two or more stressors, then you have a confrontational audience. You know what a confrontation is?
Yeah. It's like, what's up, bro?
Yeah.
What's up, bro?
You didn't eat no ice cream. You, ice cream? Get out of here. You don't know nothing about, you can't even smell ice cream.
So weird conversation. Yeah. About ice cream.
I know, but I'm trying to make a point.
Yeah.
You think you ate ice cream. This guy thinks he ate some ice cream, guys. Yeah. And you know what? Now this person needs to be put in their place. Mm-hmm. You're like, bro, wallahi, dude. Bro, I devoured that ice cream. In other words, you are confronting this person who disagrees, who doesn't believe that you ate ice cream. Mm-hmm. Okay? So two or more stresses are for a confrontational idea. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, this was all in Islamic education right now, if you didn't realize it. It was very Islamic. So now next time you're reading...
You had Wallah in there.
Yeah, you had Wallah in there, yeah. It's like, so, you know, but next time you're reading like Suratul An'am, you're like, something, why am I thinking about ice cream? Why is that happening to me? Because you're getting a quality education from Ustaz Ahmad. Anyway, so let's look at this. فَلَمَّا رَأَ الشَّمْسَ بَازِغَةً قَالَ هَذَا رَبِّي هَذَا أَكْبَرُ. When he saw the sun come out in full glory, he said, this is my master, this is greater. This is in his demonstration, remember? فَلَمَّا فَلَتْ. And when it set, meaning the sun settled, it set and sank. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ. My nation, certainly I am cut off. I have nothing. I am absolved. I am disconnected from whatever associations with God you make. Mm-hmm. Okay? So now I'll translate this last part. He said, my nation, I don't know where the... Why is there a ha there? I am disconnected. Mm-hmm. Disassociated. From the associations to Allah you make. Okay? From the shirk you do. Mm-hmm. But here he said, inni. What is inna? Children.
Inna, certainly.
Yes.
Certainly I.
Certainly. Certainly I am disconnected. This is from the associations you make. So, what does that tell you? Is this... No stressor. Is this one stressor or is this two or more stressors?
Two or more.
Where's the two?
It's one. Oh, it's not. Certainly.
Well, find me one first.
Certainly.
Certainly. Do you see any other? I don't see any other stressor.
Nah, so it's just one.
It's just one.
Yeah.
Right? And that's in the word certainly. Mm-hmm. Okay? Then, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ. When Ibrahim عليه السلام said to his father, وَقَوْمِهِ. And his nation, إِنَّنِي. It's different from inni. Mm-hmm. You see that inni?
Yeah.
It's innani, so it's a little bit different, but still means certainly I.
Yeah.
Bara'un mimma ta'budun. A little bit, it's not bari'un mimma ta'budun. It is bara'un mimma ta'budun. And it is now so certainly. Mm-hmm. Why am I spelling it that weird? Because it's not inni, it's what?
Innani.
Innani. It's more phonetic, mm-hmm. right? And then he says, I am Nahami disassociated. And I'll explain that in a second. From whatever you worship. Do you see multiple stressors?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
First of all, even the certainly is a little more stressed.
Yeah.
Because it's not just inni, it is
innani.
Then let me talk to you about disassociated. This is called a hyperbole. And you won't remember that, so I'm just telling you things that you won't remember right now, but that's okay. What I will tell you about, I'll tell you about it anyway because I love talking. And, you know, when you guys space out into like Mars, then I feel good. I feel good that I'm like, just keep talking and you're spacing out. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna do it again. I'm gonna geek out with you right now. Okay. Get ready.
Okay.
Get ready to zone out.
Okay.
So don't pay attention to anything that I'm about to say to you. Right. Got it, Maria?
Yeah.
Yeah. Forget everything I'm saying.
Okay.
Okay. It's like already done. What do you think I've been doing for the last time? Okay. I'm kidding. Okay. So how about this? A person who does good
mm-hmm.
is a good person.
Yeah.
Person who does good
mm-hmm.
is a good person. But then there's a person who does so much good.
Mm-hmm.
They do so much good that they say this person is goodness itself walking around. This is your going over the top to describe the person not just as good, but what?
The definition.
They're like the dictionary definition of goodness.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, goodness is here. Right?
Yeah.
You get it?
Yeah.
Or this person is so knowledgeable that it's like this guy's like knowledge walking around.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, man, I met knowledge the other day. So, not knowledgeable. Okay, a normal person who has knowledge, knowledgeable.
Yeah.
A person so knowledgeable that you feel like whenever you even think of them, you're like, man, when I think of this person, I just think of knowledge. Like,
mm-hmm.
this person's like knowledge walking around,
yeah.
right? Or this person is wisdom walking around.
Mm-hmm.
Or this person is so angry all the time, that dude is anger itself.
Yeah.
You get it?
Yeah.
So this is what's happening here. The word bara actually does not mean disassociated. It actually means I am disassociation itself.
Mm-hmm.
I am so disconnected from the shirk you do that I am disassociation itself walking around
mm-hmm.
from whatever you worship. From whatever you worship. And notice also here, instead of saying from the associations you make, shirk,
mm-hmm.
he used the word worship.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this is even more stress. Why? Because he's saying, you guys try to explain to me how your religion makes sense. And no, it's not shirk, it's this. I don't want to hear it. Whatever it is you worship, I am so cut off from it. It's far more aggressive language. So it's two or more stressors here,
mm-hmm.
right? What do two or more stressors tell you? Who's the audience? Remember, zero stress is
Neutral.
One stress is
doubtful.
And two or more stressors are
against people. No.
Yeah.
It's against people.
You ain't no ice cream. Remember that guy?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So this is confrontational.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The audience. This is a confrontational audience. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And this one with one disconnection is what? A doubtful audience.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So what are we learning? We're learning when he was demonstrating how absurd worshiping the sun and the moon and Jupiter are,
mm-hmm.
then people weren't sure what he's getting at.
Mm-hmm.
People were what? Doubtful.
Yeah.
What are you trying to say?
Mm-hmm.
And he, with one stressor, let them know what he's getting at.
Mm-hmm.
You people are doing shirk and I have nothing to do with it. That's what if you were confused about what I'm trying to say, here it is. One stressor.
Mm-hmm.
But by the time this message kept on coming from him, his own father and his people became so aggressive and so anti-Ibrahim alayhi salam and what he was saying that he had to respond to their confrontational. What do you mean one God? Show some respect. This is your father's religion. This is how you disrespect your father, your whole family.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have any respect for the people you live with? You know how many people you're insulting? You're making the family look bad. He's getting yelled at. People are confronting him. People are challenging him. And instead of getting backed down, he doubles down and says it with far more stress. وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ إِنَّنِي One stressor. بَرَاءٌ Two stressor. Because the normal would have been بَرِيءٌ مِمَّا تَعْبُدُونَ From whatever you worship. Another third stressor. So in doing that, he's actually shown his absolute commitment to, he's never going to budge. You know, people can say something And then when people get aggressive in their face, they're like, maybe I should back down. Maybe I should delete my post.
Yeah, Twitter.
Right? Because people are getting offended by what I said. Uh-huh. Right? Ibrahim alayhi salam said something when people aren't sure what he's getting at. Mm-hmm. As people got offended, mm-hmm. you expect him to what?
Back down.
Does this look like he's backing down?
No,
it looks like he's stressing it even harder. Oh, you want to come hard at me? Well, I have the truth. I'll come harder back at you. This is the confidence of Ibrahim alayhi salam. This is why, you know, paying attention to the details of the Arabic language in the Quran is so important. It teaches us so much about the prophets and how things escalated with them. And you can tell just from the language and the context how things used to be, you know, here where he was demonstrating, mm-hmm. to things have escalated by the time we read about it in Surah Az-Zukhruf. Mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah.
And another surah will come, and that's going to be a Madani surah where things have escalated to the far extreme. Mm-hmm. So it's going to escalate even more than that. But this shows you how things are, you know, progressing in the Quran. And these are the unfortunate things that are just completely lost in translation. We don't even realize that's happening, mm-hmm. right? So that's a really remarkable thing, that how Allah Azza wa Jal showed us the difference between those two things, and how actually, one more comment here, that you remember I said somebody that is, you know, that somebody that is so much, has so much knowledge, they learn so much that they're just knowledge walking around.
Yeah.
You know what that means? That they are, when you think of them, you think of them as someone who's constantly learning, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
Or someone who's always patient. They're just patience walking around. Mm-hmm. So the fact that he's calling himself Bara'a, he's actually saying, everything I do mm-hmm. says one thing. I got nothing to do with you people. Mm-hmm. Like, it's not just, oh, if you ask me, I have nothing to do with you. I am nothing to do with you-ness walking around. Mm-hmm. Everything I do disconnects from you. Right, so it's a very aggressive, very, you know, outright form of his expression to his people, and that's captured in the remarkable courage of Ibrahim alayhi salam in the way Allah describes it. So, with that, inshallah, I'll conclude today's example, and may Allah azza wa jalla make us have the confidence of Ibrahim alayhi salam, that when people are in doubt, we're able to make our convictions clear, and when people are hateful towards us, confrontational towards us about what we believe, when we know something to be right, that we stand by what is right because we have the word of Allah with us. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Hakim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikr al-Hakim.
Assalamu alaikum, guys. Remember, do your best and Allah will do the rest. See you guys tomorrow. Inshallah.
I shall have green sauce for